Hoërskool, time to the Hoërskool Lichtenburg, and lead by 17 points to 9. They've scored the two converted tries and a penalty against the three penalties. And we'll have a look at the highlights.
It was a perfect start from Klerksdorp with a take at the back of the liner from Barlow Jones. All going to hand of their captain, Rieder, and the rest is history, crashing over.
That try well converted by Hoch.
Platform is set. Leg drive, body positions are very good, nice and low, working together as a unit.
This certainly the movement of the game. Rieder, watch the timing of the pass. Fantastic. Another leg, he gets rid of one, gets rid of another via a body lunge, and then celebrates a very good try. Also converted by Hoch, and there were three penalties by Oosthuizen for Lichtenburg.
What made this try was the quality of the timing of passes between Heyman and then from Rieder to Maluleke. Maluleke is showing some great skill. Power step into the tackle using the handoff. Superb work.
Ball perfectly placed under the right arm so he could use the left hand for the bend. There we have the stats. Vim.
Well, it's pretty clear. Possession going the way of Klerksdorp. Deserved lead is 17 points to 9. The amount of missed tackles from Lichtenburg could be a problem. What's made it for Lichtenburg is the amount of times they've visited the opposition's 22. They've been there three times. They've come away with 9 points. Their boot off, Oosthuizen, has kept them in the game.
So the various coaches have gone through their normal ritual. It's a normal thing. Guys, you're making too many mistakes. You mark to feel photo and saying keep the ball in hand. You don't stop the mistakes, keep the ball in hand. Heard the Klerksdorp coach saying, don't try all this fancy stuff, just get the ball out to the wings, back up, continuity, handling and continuity. Good coaching. Now the Lichtenburg coach, also the two coaches there, Nordia Pinar, Heinrich Horn. I must say that one of the things that Lichtenburg haven't managed to do is dominate the Klerksdorp pack.
Well, coming into the game, they seem to have a bigger and stronger pack of forwards as the Lichtenburg side. But I must say, Klerksdorp has stood up to the task. They've actually looked pretty good at scrum time. Lichtenburg, on the other hand, need to get some quality possession or first phase ball.
See the pictures of all the players that are displayed in front of the grandstand. I say before the game we had quite a situation in terms of the rituals and the school songs, and let's say not rituals, traditions.
Well, it is fantastic for these youngsters. If they don't go to play any higher honors than this could be one of their greatest moments in their rugby career, running out for their school in an FNB Classic Clash and giving it horns.
Crowd enjoying the game, enjoying the atmosphere. Some of them don't watch too much of the rugby. They chat about what's been going on with the kiddies and stuff. So Renier Kutsia will get the final 35 minutes gain and see whether the school playing at home can get a win. Spread both sides are the Klerksdorp players, and Rieder takes well. Good chase up by Lichtenburg.
Take him back.
Strong ball for Klerksdorp. Pretorius Hoch. That's the sort of thing that the coach was talking about. But Waldeck did well. Scores also with a little run there.
No tackle.
Continuity is good by Klerksdorp, but then the Lichtenburg players come away with the advantage. This is good for the boys in white, taking the ground there by Carroll. Now Klaassen. Klaassen did very well to get that ball to Meyer. Lichtenburg, as they said earlier, were going to use their forwards. Van Seld is looking for a bit of an opening that wasn't there. Continuity with the forwards. Carroll, Pretorius, Ackermann, the front rankers, working hard along with their forwards. Van der Berg and Klaassen, the locks. Now, chance here for Willem Swanepoel. Ball going to ground. Lichtenburg advantage.
Well, both sides pouncing on errors from either side. The men in white, Lichtenburg, getting the ball on a turnover and working the way upfield, picking and going, keeping it tight. An error coming in and Klerksdorp high. Just trying to force the play with an offload and a knock-on coming in.
Well, the crowd enjoying themselves. Real derby day here in Klerksdorp. Super May Day.
Well, that's what it's all about, an FNB Classic Clash. It's about the family getting together, having a good time around this rugby field. There's a lot of spirit. There's a lot of hush in the crowd at the moment, but it's a lovely atmosphere.
Ari van der Berg is okay to go, the lock forward of Lichtenburg.
Keep the space.
And Van Sail with the feed.
Steady.
Use it once and they obey the referee's instruction. Good play by Captain Detman. Coming for, or rather slowly, the forwards pick and go. It was a hard-working Hatton van Heerden who wasn't able to control the ball ultimately.
Just knocking it on as he picked it up, trying to go in the pick and go, the direct route. Klerksdorp with a chance at scrum time to feed. In the form of little Anke Pretorius.
Fine. Set. Steady. Steady.
Scrum infringement by Lichtenburg.
Going against Peter Carroll for losing his bind. And up front in the front row, it's all about safety. It's about getting a good bind, a good body position, not to be overextended and keep that scrum up.
Well, it's a super kick by Fly Half Hoog. He's kicked two conversions and one long range penalty, which was a wonderful affair. A wonderful effort, should I say, and now has kicked a really long touch finder. Desperate lunge by Oosthuizen to get the ball. Clean line out ball for Klerksdorp. Pretorius, Hoog. Basson. It comes out on the side of Lichtenburg, booted away by Oosthuizen. Long way for Scholz to go. On the bounce, and he's evaded the first one well. Good following up also by fullback Dupree for Lichtenburg. Piling in go Klerksdorp to secure the ball.
Use it.
That's pretty good play. Oh, and the counter ruck is good. Picked up though by Swanepoel. Hoog. Oh, now away for Oosthuizen. Little chance here for Steinbach. Steinbach, can he go all the way now? It's the fullback, and Steinbach finds the man on the inside. It's Passon. Very quickly there to the break was reared up. Now it's with Heymans. Coming away for Pretorius. Hoch. Good ball away, but not handled pretty well. Another chance for the counter from Lichtenburg. Malalecki is back for it. The chase coming well. Malalecki trying to get rid of Maria. And now it's with Grieda. Stays on his feet well through the tackle of Carroll. Heavily built Carroll, who came off second best on that tackle on Rieda. Hoch a chance to launch his backs again. Finds the loose head Pretorius. Continuity with Malalecki in possession now.
Oh.
Can they get it to ground? Can they get it out of the mall? Worked up again. In goes Basson. Worked up by the scrum half Pretorius. Now Rieda. Ooh, and it's a good tackle. Continuity is good by Kroonstadt though. And the penalty goes the way of the defending side. There were quite a few first aid people on the field then. They were players were having to evade them as well as would-be tacklers. Oosthuizen.
It was a good build-up from Klerksdorp Hoër. Just unfortunately not getting numbers to the ruck. Good work from Lichtenburg on the ground, getting ball on hand and managing the steal and getting the penalty.
Richard Pretorius to feed the line-out. Just a tap on the ball by Van der Berg. Loose forwards have done well. That time again, Van Heerden has worked pretty hard today. Not making a lot of ground though, Lichtenberg, as Van Sel digs for the ball. Nice timing of the pass for Mathewson. Waldeck is back. Comes to Malalecki. Now we'll see the pace of the man, or the young man, should I say. Oh, and it's a good tackle, super tackle there, coming in from Francois Nietlin. Malalecki was looking very promising, and Nietlin was up to the task.
That was a wonderful bootleg tackle from Francois Nietlin. Let me tell you one thing, Malalecki is quick, he's elusive, he can step. It's a wonderful play, good timing of the pass from Rudolf Oosthuizen. Malalecki with a bit of space, and he's got a lot of pace. Steps inside, bang, up to the tackle, perfect stuff.
Six.
Van Sale, Oosthuizen, Boshoff, Oosthuizen, lovely double around. Ooh, maybe that ball should have gone out. It was Nietling again in the back line. Promising move. It's won them a penalty, but I think the pass was on there for Nietling, who had doubled around after that terrific tackle on Malalecki. Included in that move.
Oh, it was definitely on out wide. They doubled around well, they created space out wide. Their wing and fullback had kept depth. See out there, there's a lot of space and there's a lot of pace. They should have got that ball out wide.
Well, it's a good position this for Lichtenburg. Up goes Van Heerden, and the barge for the line is good by Lichtenburg. Van Sel was got it away, a try for Lichtenburg. And it's the big number five, Mauritius Klaassen, who banged it over the whitewash.
Well, it is Lichtenburg that have drawn first blood in the second half from a well-worked move from the line-out. But Marissa's class and too much strength. Body position is good, and he crashes over.
Conversion by Worsthuizen is good, so Lichtenburg trail by 1 point.
Good work. Started from a line-out move, a starter move, where the ball came off the top to their captain, Johan Detman. Good recycle, good continuity. Marissa's Klaassen too strong.
Good chase up by Klerksdorp, and the penalty goes the way of the home team. So we'll see what Captain Rieder decides to do here. Hoog will kick for goal.
Three.
It was a good hanging kick.
Bring safely to ground.
From Erik Hoog. Getting players under the ball, giving time. Sides were the Lichtenburg forwards.
Well, so far we've had 7 kicks at goal and all have been successful. And it's 8 out of 8 for the two kickers, extending their lead. What wonderful place kicking.
It was a lovely strike from Hoog. And it looked like nowhere, going nowhere else but besides, straight through the middle of the uprights.
Oh, it's a good chase up and find the passer finding Malaleke. It was by Nyethlum. Away by Rieda. Was captain against captain there, and Rieda looked like he came off the better one. They're both sturdily built young boys. Now Worsthuizen. Waldeck. Ooh, he managed to control. He's got a good step on him as Waldeck, as he shows there. Then the ball away for Scholes. Lovely ball. Scholes has got pace. And he goes inside, outside, and gets away from his man. Although he carries the ball in the wrong arm, beautiful inside-out swerve by the left winger, and a superb try for Klerksdorp.
Oh, what a superb try, but who made this try? Is his teammate Waldeck stepping in and out, and the offload and the tackle was excellent. In the finishing, from Scholes, was outstanding. Slowing down, cracking on the pace, doing a little goose step a la David Campisi, and going over.
Well, 2 scores within a minute maybe will have knocked the spirit of Lichtenburg. Can they come back into the game? It will be a tough ask now. Hoog with, well, I was about to say his most difficult kick, but he had a penalty from the halfway line. This, obviously, from a more difficult angle. No, he hasn't hit that well at all. So the first failure of the day by either kicker. Now, the big point is when he is the ability to dodge somebody. The pass away was terrific. Got away from his man. Now, you see, he outfoxes a would-be defender, and a wonderful bit of dodging.
It was superb stuff.
Well taken by Barlow Jones. All the loose forwards have had good games today. Hoch. Then for Heymans.
Release blow.
Pretorius. Hoch. Oh, difficult ball, well fielded by Duan de Prier. Very well done by the fullback. Now, one would hope that Klerksdorp are not going to sit back and defend their lead. We have a replacement on the park. It is Brandon Nell in the number 20 jersey. Strong tackling by Klerksdorp.
It's almost as if Klerksdorp have upped and gone to another gear. But strong defense in your face. Good tackle from Barlow Jones. I must say, I've been impressed with this loose forward trio of Klerksdorp the whole afternoon. They've looked for work, they've been good in defense. Rieder Swanepoel and Barlow Jones have definitely set the bar in this FNB Classic Clash.
Safe.
Pretorius, Hoch. Well, it was sort of a speculative run and then just gave the ball away there, but the kick for touch is good. And really keeping Lichtenburg on the back foot.
Well, definitely so, getting front forward ball. Anker Pretorius judging his box kick, chip kick to perfection. So they find themselves once again in the pressure cooker zone.
Pretorius with the throw. It's well taken by Detman. The referee indicating that there was obstruction there. The players, you see, Detman went up and then players moved in behind Detman with the wedge. Now Rieda, oh, and it's an easy try for the big front ranker.
Rieda taking responsibility, the captain of Klerksdorp. What he did was he held on to that pass. Drew all the defense, everyone expecting him to crash it up, just slipping a little pass to the hooker, who's had a prominent afternoon. Ulu Heyman crashes over for a try.
Well, in the matter of 5 minutes, Klerksdorp have gone from a score of 17 points to 16 to 30 points to 16 in just 5 minutes. Another good-looking strike, and it's over.
Good rugby players, a rugby player that has vision. Rieder definitely does have vision. He knew the support was out wide. He knew he was coming from depth. He drew everyone in and just popped it out wide.
Good follow-up again by Niethling. He chases a kick horse very well, does the left winger. Been impressed with the work of Hurton van Heerden as well. Tertius Wursthuizen, man penalized. Wursthuizen, the fly half for Lichtenburg, finds a good touch.
Offsides was Tertius Wursthuizen not retreating behind the last man's feet. Lichtenburg stands for the town of Light Hue, and they definitely need some light to shine in them now.
these players right down in front of us now.
Six.
Vital line-out for Lichtenburg. They've gone to Carson most of the time. They've also used their number six goes there again, Van Heerden. Can they use their tower here? Although I must say, just having a look at the size of Elo Heymans, who scored the try, he's a big hooker, as are the other two men in the front row. Should I say young men? Little high five amongst them.
It was well taken at the back of the line out from Van Heerden. Well defended from Klerksdorp getting in. Cole can use it, so therefore Klerksdorp will have the put in at scrum time.
Crouch. Bind. Sick.
Pretorius, ooh, there's pressure here. Nice little bit of footwork by Hoch. Super clearance by the fly half, didn't panic, was under pressure, and then used the sidestep beautifully.
Five.
Nelv tidied up well, Rieda. Pretorius. Now it's Swanepoel went to ground. Turnover ball for Lichtenburg. They desperately need a score very soon, otherwise they are going to lose this game.
12. Lost the step.
Fun sale. Klaassen comes around. Good bit of footwork by him. In fact, it was Jetman, the number eight. Unfortunately, Lichtenburg just losing control in the vital situations.
That last little pass that doesn't go to hand.
No numbers.
Putting them under immense pressure because they're losing possession. And you say it all the time, continuity. They need continuity. They need ball retention.
The ball for Pretorius. Hoch. Not a bad hoist by the fly half. Well taken by Niethling. Chased by Maluleki. Taken to ground by Funnebach. Now the chase is on. Well played and well covered by Uncle Pretorius. Did very well to get back there, the scrum half, and Klerksdorp win the penalty.
Well, it was well read by a little scrum half, Rabia van Sale from Lichtenburg. He knew that Maluleki was involved in the defensive situation when he chased the chip kick of Hoch. Well fielded from his opposition number. Anka Pretorius doing really well, putting the ball back. Nice and long, a long ruck. Good work.
Tertius Wisthuizen just will have to receive a little bit of attention. Taken by Andre Pretorius, not 5 meters. By Klerksdorp. Lichtenburg need to lift their game. Flanker Gerard Meyer trying to wrestle it away. That's better play by Lichtenburg. Wisthuizen. Good running by the fly half. Must find a man. This is good play by the white shirted boys. And over. Over they go. Terrific try. A really good try there by Henrique Maria. For the first time, every pass went to hand. They passed it well. A great work by the fly half.
Well, he did superbly well. His worst days and his timing of his passes, he stepped inside. I thought he actually made a hash of it when he did step inside, but he had enough pace to finally support out wide. And Maria finishing off.
Will it, no, just stays wide. Good attempt by Worsthuizen. But I said, watch, here we go, Worsthuizen on the run.
He steps inside, but his timing of pass to finally support out wide was excellent. Bit of soft defense from Klerksdorp. They slipped off tackles, but Maria did very well to stay on his feet. Leg drive, he knew where that try line was, and he finished off even better.
Good chase up again. Now Worsthuizen, they're running the ball from everywhere now. Lichtenburg, and it's paying off. Silpen back in their own half though. They need to keep the ball in field as Nietling did get it in field. Can Lichtenburg control? Looks like Klerksdorp, no, turnover. Pretorius, chase up on Nietling. In the air, so Lichtenburg win the penalty, but they trail by 11.
Well, I thought he timed it to perfection. Look at that step. As he goes to ground, he's already holding that left hip. Looks like he's hurt himself, maybe pulled a little muscle.
Well, he's staying on the field as the left winger, but there is a tension. Good work again by Van Heerden. Detman just unable to find the man on the outside. Strong defense by both sides in that little period of play. Well, the subs will start coming onto the field now. It's the old story. No sooner do you get to know the 30 players on the field, but the new guys come on. It will be Jaco Lombard comes on for Lichtenburg.
Looks like Lombard has replaced Boshoff. In the previous replay, we saw him clutching his left hip. Went down.
Crouch. Bye. Set.
Solid by, well, they win the penalty out of it. Klerksdorp scrum was solid.
Three white, binding.
We heard the call clearly by the referee, Rainier Kutsia. The binding of the tight head prop, Oki Ackerman.
The kick away by Hoog. Good touch finder.
Well, time is running out with 5 minutes of play left and possession to Klerksdorp.
Taken by Nell. Now they pile into the mall to the other Klerksdorp forwards. Can they burst away with it? Rieder doing strong work. In fact, also Willem Swanepoel working strongly in that maul. Bruce Smith, the tight head prop. Four minutes to go now. A bit of a problem for one of the players here. Oh, it looks like that blood situation again. Richard Pretorius. They'll have to get a hooker on. It'll probably be Svia Conradi. Next up, DHS against Glenwood. Big derby game in Durban.
Crouch.
DHS have produced more national cricketers than any other school in South Africa over the years. Deliberate wheel. You can see the indication by the referee. Looks like he's doing the twist. Worst Tyson. So the sands of time running out for Hoërskool Lichtenburg. Looks like Klerksdorp again to win this game. And this is some incredible turnaround. Two tries they need in a matter of a couple of minutes. Nice tap down for the liner. Chance for Hoërskool to get his backs moving. Detman was in the back line. We've seen good distribution from the Klerksdorp number 8 Rieder, South African under 18 player. Yeah, the big men come again. That time it was Peter Carroll, but they're running out of space. Hands above the tackle by Francois Nyethlem. Detman again. Away by Van Sail. Oosthuizen. Nicely timed pass for Van Heerden. They need to get that ball wider. Away by Maria. Good control again by Van Heerden. So Lichtenburg get the penalty. Will they tap and go? Will they form a line out? Moving up to just a minute to go. Detman. Well tackled there by Bruce Smith. Now with Carroll. Pick up and go by Robbie Van Sail. Strong defense by his opposite number, Anker Pretorius.
So
not 10, they'll go again. Van Sail popping it up to Meyer. That's the corner flag there. They mustn't get white line fever, Lichtenburg, if they want to just get a face-saving try here. Good take by Oosthuizen. Then away for Lombard.
No advantage.
Van Sail looking to go quickly.
Too many penalties.
Van Sail for Ackerman. Penalty goes the way of Klerksdorp. Obstruction. We see that. JC Hutton's been on the field a little while now for Klerksdorp. Maluleki staying down, but look where he is from the right wing position. And And that is it. That is it. This FNB Classic Clash is won by the home side, the Hoërskool Klerksdorp. KHS, the victors over Lichtenburg. It's been quite an entertaining game with four tries scored by Klerksdorp, two by Lichtenburg. We've seen some good loose forward play. We've seen some good kicking, place kicking from both fly halves, and one or two really super tries. There were one in particular by Scholz and the one by Maluleki earlier on were real beauties. Game played in superb spirit and a well-behaved crowd. Quiet when the kickers kicked. And so there we have it. The final score, 32 points to 21. We'll be back for the interviews a little later.